Hello everyone and welcome to a new video. Today I want to feature a team that was, at least I believe, created from a fellow content creator, 64Ninja. I'm gonna link the Twitch channel and his Twitter down in the description, at least if I remember it. And yeah, this is a premiere, ultra premiere team. Most of you might know it. It's the Double Dragon team with Empoleon. He has used multiple variations of it. I believe right now he's using Togekiss instead of Dragonite, or at least I think he used to do that last season. And yeah, this team has no XL Pokemon, and I believe it is still pretty strong. Yeah, it consists out of Empoleon in the lead, normal moveset, Waterfall, Hydrocan and Drill Pack. Then the safe switch, which is Kingdra, with Dragon Breath, Octazooka and Outrage. And as a finisher, the Dragonite with Dragon Breath, Dragon Claw and Hurricane. Yeah, the way you play this team is you often, if you don't like get your Charmer in the lead or like a fire type, you switch out of it into the Kingdra to lure out their anti-dragon Pokemon. Yeah, then you hopefully are able to close out the game with the Dragonite. I do believe this team is pretty good right now because all three Pokemon are doing well against the new hyped up Talonflame XL. Yeah. I did my first three battles in Ultra League with it, and let's see how it went. So as you see, I'm still not ranked 20 yet, and we're getting matched up against the Swampert. This matchup is kinda even. I'm getting notification, and yeah, it's... I obviously resist the Hydro Cannon, but I do not want to take the Earthquake. I'm switching out after they shielded, right? We are shield advantage. And they switch into XL Mandibuzz. I believe that is a level 40. I'm gonna go straight for the Outrage. Mandibuzz is super tanky, so I don't expect it to shield. And unless I would have gotten the debuff with Octazooka, it would have been, yeah, kind of a waste. And yeah, here I'm trying to get to another Octazooka, but they throw the energy. And carry. That is fine. I come back into Empoleon, and yeah, this is a lot of farm, right? A lot of farm. They switch into Swampert right here, aggressive switch. I do want to keep my Empoleon, and I switch out immediately to Dragonite because I knew that they had back to back, and I do catch the move. This is just another Hydro Cannon. I can't take it, and I'm gonna let it go. Here I do a mistake. I should have obviously found a Dragonclaw. I believe in the end it does not matter though. So now it's about not throwing the move into their Mandibuzz, which was still alive. I was patient, and they actually switched into the Waterfall, which KO'd their Mandibuzz. And yeah, we KO'd right here. GG! Next game. Here's the Pokemon that I spoke of, Talonflame. They switch out of it. I am going for a Drill Pack. Hydrocan is double resisted. And I do switch into my Dragonite right here. I do switch into Dragonite in case they have a like Dragon Answer in the back. They go for the Octazooka instead of the Outrage. That's fine though. And yeah, Talonflame comes back. And we hit him with the Dragon Claws. We have a lot of energy. We farmed down the Kingdra, and yeah, they faint. In comes the Machamp. Dragonite applies a lot of shield pressure, yet another Dragon Claw. This is a little bit tricky because they do have some energy. I do shield this right here. And I don't want to get farmed down. And then have them throwing a grass chop onto my Empoleon, so I aggressively switch out, because that means they do have to throw their energy. I even survive it, and even if I wouldn't have survived it, that one waterfall damage would have been enough in order for the Kingdra to drain with it down. Let's go into the next match. I think this one arrowed out. Yeah, I'm stuck right here. I'm a little bit worried. I was like, oh no, please, please don't throw me into a game where my Pokemon is already farmed down to like half health. Luckily, it didn't happen. Just an arrow out. And yeah, Dragonite lead. They actively switch into the Venusaur. I was like a little bit hesitating, but yeah, then I go into my own Dragonite. I do shield up the Sludge Bomb. I thought it was unlikely that they would shield right away. Bait right away. And yeah, I can safely no shield the second Sludge Bomb. And yeah, then I farm it down. I do have some energy build up, so if the Dragonite comes in again. Yeah, and here comes a Reuniclus. I was hella surprised. I don't even know what moves this has. But yeah, I don't think it's a good Pokemon, because it just faints here. And yeah, now I show my Kingdra, and yeah, I believe they gave up soon, because there's no way to win. Yeah, reasonable play from them. GG. Game three in the back. I think I had to quickly answer the message. That's why we're waiting in the you win screen. And yeah, I've seen quite a few Talonflames. Not like an insane amount, but they're definitely out there. And you have to be prepared. Okay, this is a bad lead. Fighter, a tanky fighter on top of it. I do switch to the Kingdra. I think they're baiting right here. And yeah, they do. And now let's switch out. Octazooka obviously doing super effective damage. I'm not sure why they switched out, because they're not using Dragon Breath. So I decide to shield and just farm it down. In comes the Venusaur. Gonna go straight Outrage. Either I'm gonna get a shield or take a lot of HP from this. This is not the greatest position ever. So I go for a risky play and try to catch a move, because I had to do something in order to come back, and we do catch the fancy plant. I was scared that this was what was maybe some hard hitting move, so I do shield it. Probably in hindsight, I probably shouldn't. They probably used a cross chop. Yeah, and we do get to a last second Dragon Claw, which takes it out. Now I'm gonna switch to not give them any farm with the Venusaur, because they need two Frenzy Plants. The Steel Typing of Empoleon makes up for the Water weakness. And yeah, I do land the Drill Pack, and that's yet another game. Get a quick match. Let's see, can I make it 5 out of 5? Drifblim. I saw a surprisingly high amount of Drifblims. I do get the voice message right there. And yeah, they threw the Icy Wind. I think it was actually not even a bait. And yeah, they switched into their Lapras. I do soften the Lapras up with a Drill Pack. And yeah, they were going for like, they're building up for not enough for the Skullbash, but way more than the Surf. So I figured they probably would go for the Ice Beam. And yeah, we do land at the Outrage. They bait right here. In this situation, I did not feel like using any shields, because I was just in a good position and felt like there was only upsides for me if I not shield, in case they do bait like they did. Here I did a mistake. I probably should have gone into the Empoleon. I switch out of the Dragon Knight to clear the debuff. We do land the Hydro Cannon. They go for the Earthquake. And yeah, now they are lost. This is not Shadow Dragon Knight, so it can survive the Hydro Cannon stay. Probably should have shielded my Hydro Cannon. I don't think it would have ended way better for them though. Alright, and that's it. That's it for the video. As you were able to see in the last second of the video, that was a 5-0. And I played more games with this team already. And all sets were positive. I could have had another 5-0 and another 4-1. I misplayed in both of them though, so it was only a 3-2 and a 4-1 instead. But yeah, positive results. And if you're still looking for a team and you don't have the XL candy, maybe you're not level 40 yet, you cannot receive XL candy. Shout out to you, Aragorn's my king. Yeah, then this team is definitely something that you should try. You only need one legacy move, right? Only the Empoleon with the Hydro Cannon. But yeah, if you are playing the community days, you should have that. You should have that. And if you don't have it, you can try to use Snorlax instead. But I would prefer the Empoleon right now, just because of Talonflame. And overall, it just deals a little bit better with the Charmers. Alright, that's it. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you can catch you soon on the live stream. And yeah, have a nice day. Peace out.